Self-driving cars may sound pretty cool, but 81% of us have never been in one, according to a poll out just this year. So what are they like on the road, and why are some calling their widespread use inevitable? Chris Harapsky puts a few to the test.
Driving is changing. The latest race is to erase the driver.
I am just completely blown away by what the technology has enabled.
Phil Magny, owner of VSI Labs in St. Louis Park, has been testing self-driving technology for a decade. He says full autonomous cars are inevitable. But from here, it gets tricky.
It's really not a technology problem anymore. It's all about how it's implemented.
We wanted to see the best self-driving features a Minnesotan can purchase right now. First stop, Maury's Golden Valley Cadillac.
This is the Cadillac Lyriq.
The all-electric Lyriq features big screens, bright colors, and caddy comfort equipped with GM's Level 2 self-driving Super Cruise.
You'll be able to take your hands completely off of the wheel, kind of take a break from the driving experience, and just let the car do it for you.
All right, you ready to rock and roll?
For now, Super Cruise only works on highways, so that's where we headed.
Press that Super Cruise button whenever you're ready.
I'm ready.
Now let go of the steering wheel.
And the gas. All right, and we're hot. So I'm off the wheel, I'm off the brake, I'm off the gas. The car is essentially driving itself right now.
It uses sensors, cameras, and GPS to ensure you're staying in your lane. It will adjust to traffic speed and make lane changes for you.
I put my blinker on. It's looking for an opening. It changes lanes without me touching the gas, brake, or wheel.
The car also keeps an eye out for your eyes. If they stray from the road, this happens.
Oh, there it goes.
Super Cruise unavailable, looked away for too long.
The Super Cruise disengaged a few other times, once under an overpass, likely due to GPS, we're told, and once on a merge.
I see how it decides which curve to go here. It doesn't like it. Asked me to take over.
In both instances, the car didn't know what to do, so it defaulted back to me, the driver, for control. Next stop, Sears Imported Auto.
This is the Mercedes-Benz S580.
This is the grandpapa, the flagship of Mercedes-Benz. And at 140 grand, no comfort corner is cut.
Level 2 was what we're going to do today, which is cooperative self-driving.
This feature is like the Caddy, but can work on most roads, keeping you in lane and at speed. But it won't follow nav directions or react to traffic lights. That's on you still.
So we're hot and we're sudden.
It's got active steering assist going, active lane keep assist, and active assist distronic. If it starts slowing down too much and sees an open lane, it'll recommend a lane change and just do it.
Last year, Mercedes became the first consumer car to breach level 3 autonomy, which means the car will drive you without any supervision from the driver. This mode, called Drive Pilot, only works in highway traffic under 40 miles an hour and is only available currently in California and Nevada.
And you don't have to pay attention at all. You close your eyes.
Sure.
Mercedes will handle the liability of that.
100% Mercedes-Benz, because it's level 3 autonomous driving, is taking responsibility for the vehicle when that mode is engaged.
The Mercedes was comparable to the Cadillac, but for our drive, it never needed to disengage. It handled every decision smoothly. It was now time to try Tesla. We asked the company if it wanted to participate in this story. We got no response from the corporate office. Thankfully, Phil Magny let us drive his.
This is a Tesla Model Y Long Range.
This SUV-ish model lacks some of the luxury features of the other two cars we tried, but its single large screen and full self-driving mode are the wow factors.
It's reconstructing the scene, so it's using all of its cameras to piece it all together.
We asked it to take us to Care 11.
All right, and we're in auto.
From there, the car drove us.
This thing is driving itself through the city.
From intersections to on-ramps.
We're gonna get on the freeway here. I'm not touching the wheel.
To complex roundabouts.
Enter, turn. Wow, it nailed it.
It was as close to full autonomous driving that there is today.
What do people say to you when they experience this level of autonomy for the first time?
Well, they're just completely amazed by it.
But its supervision still requires supervision. It made a few mistakes in our test.
Wait, it just broke the law. Oh, I didn't know it was left turn only lane. Okay.
Went straight in a turn lane there.
Get over quick. Get over quick. Well, car's coming behind us.
Hey, look at this.
Okay, yep. Messed up.
Yep.
All right, good. I'm taking over.
And it failed to merge when other cars were in the way. Outside that, the car did what no other car can do today. Autonomous driving is the next major evolution in automobiles. Buckle up. The future is coming fast. Chris Arabsky, Care 11 News.
Well, despite all these advancements, according to a poll by Forbes Advisor, 93% have concerns about some aspect of self-driving cars, with safety and technology malfunctions topping the list.